10 different PETG brands. Is there any bigger difference between them? Let's find out. Hello, welcome to my tech farm. I have here 10 different PETG filaments from different brands and I want to compare them. Something similar I did almost 2 years ago with 16 PLA brands. From some reason that video was not too popular, so I lost the motivation, but finally I decided to finish this video too, because almost all these filaments I bought 2 years ago, except the bamboo lab, it is only half years old. Now what will I test? Well, things which are important for the PETG over PLA. One of those is the temperature resistance, so I place all test objects in the oven and I will follow the deformation temperature. The next is the impact test, and this is interesting because many users claim that PETG is tougher material compared to the PLA. Now I checked my summary table, you know, for my Patreon supporters, I have there more than 100 testings, and actually there the average value on that ISO impact test for the PLA is 2 times bigger compared to the PETG. So what's happening here? Well, I noticed that the PETG is more flexible, especially the filament itself. The PLA is very brittle. If you have some older PLA material, try to bend it and there is a big chance that it will break in 2 pieces. The big difference is actually in the flexing. The PETG will start with the flexing before the break until the PLA will break more suddenly, but that load will be 2 times bigger average value compared to the PETG. So this is probably the reason why most of the users think that PETG is more tougher material. But actually this is a good property in most cases, because this is some kind of warning for us that, hey, be careful because it may break now soon. PLA will break suddenly without this kind of warning. The third thing I will test is the creeping. Now here again the PLA is stronger compared to the PETG, but only on the room temperature. If we have at least, I don't know, 30, 35 degrees Celsius, definitely things change and the PLA will deform quite quickly. So I want to compare some kind of creep test, but a longer one, maybe 2 weeks, and I will measure the test objects after 1 week. And of course I want to test the regular things like the layer adhesion, but with the test object vertically printed with 2 walls and 20% infill, because this is closer to that realistic printing, and of course some kind of tensile pulling test. Now let's see what filaments I have here. I already mentioned I bought them 2 years ago. This is Sanlu, Isan, and then I know in US these three are very popular: Amazon Basics, Overture, Hedgebox. This is Creality, and these 4 are already opened, but I store them in these resealable bags with some desiccant inside. This is a Prusa PETG, Polymakers Polylight version, Bamboo Lab, and this is Everyone PETG. I know that even the color may have effect to these results from the same brand, but I believe the difference shouldn't be so big for one brand. Actually, this is something what I will test in very near future for PLA Plus. I already have those filaments, and maybe even for the PETG. I will check the print settings, but I will choose one actually, because all test objects I want to print using the same G-code on Prusa Mark 4. The reason I chose this printer, one of it is it is quietest, and I will be next to it working here in this room. And the second is actually the Prusa has great profiles for PETG filaments, because these parts are actually made from PETG, and Prusa has the biggest print farm, and they really fine-tune those PETG profiles. Before the printing, each filament will get 2 hours of drying, and the printing will be from the opener, and during the printing of one filament, the other will be in the filament dryer. And with this we will have more equal conditions. As you can see, I placed back this equal lack enclosure, but there are no doors, so this will be not printing inside the enclosure. I just need the holders for this equipment on the top. Objects in the Prusa slicer, and here you can see those vertical test objects are hollow inside with 2 walls and 20% infill, 245 and 90 degrees Celsius on the nozzle and the bed, and the cooling is between 30 and 50% and 10 cubic meters per second is the flow rate, but the real speed will be lower. I will print everything using the same G-code. The start is good, but I shouldn't have any problem with this kind of sheets. The start is good, and for each filament I will show you the final result, so we can check the quality if there is any problem like stringing or similar. Polymaker, Prusament, Everyone. Just a quick note, after it's printing, this is Bamboo Lab PETG Basic, and this is Creality PETG, and I placed it inside this bag more than a year ago, and it still holds the vacuum. Bubble PETG Basic, Creality. I think it's worth to mention that with Amazon Basic we get this resealable bag too, but the packaging is not vacuum packaging.
But only two holes for the locking end of the filament. Amazon Basics.
Hedgebox, it has great vacuum packaging.
Hedgebox. The overture arrives in nice vacuum packaging, and this type of the material is much better against the moisture. And also we will get a small build plate, 20 by 20 centimeters. And this bag is resealable, just cut it above the ceiling line, and I'm very curious how transferable will be this material.
Overture, and this is an interesting one, I can see the infill lines of this vertical test object.
E-Sun and Sunloop, both in dark colors, this is black and this is some kind of dark gray, and nice vacuum packaging in both cases.
Sunloop and E-Sun. These are PETG filaments. ABS and ASA, nylon and polycarbonate. Each material is printed and labeled, ready for mechanical testing. These test objects are printed in horizontal position. I'm starting with the Prusa MK4, Polymaker, Cambulab, Creality, Sunloop, Pisan, Overture, Everyone, Amazon Basics, Hedgebox. And they broke very similarly, and actually on a similar load, there is no big difference between them. Now with the layer adhesion there will be bigger differences, so I changed the order. This is now from the lowest to the highest. Creality, Tensile, Amazon Basics, Sunloop, Overture, Polymaker, Prusa MK4, Hedgebox, Everyone, Pembulet. The brake load was different, but they look very equal after this testing. These are the loads, 1.25 kg for my creep test, where I want to measure the deformation under the constant load. And for this I have these C test objects. You can see this many times in my earlier videos. I'm placing them on this shaft, which will be outside next 7 days. Here you can see their initial shape. And I'm placing the loads and immediately I'm locking the position and I'm measuring the distance between two reference surfaces. Without load, the distance is 12 millimeters. This is the first day of the creep test. I already measured them and I will not measure them every day, only 1 week later. Until that, they will be here outside on open air, but under the roof, so they will not be exposed to sun or to the rain. But to the temperature dilatation, yes. Here you can see the temperatures planned in the next 7 days. And I will measure them only on last day, 7th, to see what will be the deformation. This is day 8, and the last 2 days were extremely hot, over 30 degrees Celsius. But I cannot see much more deformation on these test objects compared to the second day. I will measure them down and then I can see the results. After this I'm removing the loads. And I'm placing them next to each other to see some permanent deformation. And here you can see them side by side. On this graph you can see the dimensions on day 0 and 8, and with yellow points this is the difference in percentage, more or less around 10%, no big difference between them, but in this case the Prusa MK4 was the best and the Bambulab was the worst. The temperature test in the oven when I want to record the temperature of the first deformation. I have this M10 nuts as a small load, and I'm following the temperature with the cooking thermometer. This is speed up time-lapse video. And more or less they all start with a deformation around 65 degrees Celsius. I had to analyze footage frame by frame to see any difference between them. And even for the feeling I cannot see any difference between these test objects. Only on Bambulab PETG I can see a little bit more shrinking compared to the other materials. 3-point bending test with my new equipment, which follows better the ISO 178 standard. Distance between supports is 64 millimeters. The load will be 2.5 kilograms and I want to record the deformation after exactly 10 seconds. After this I'm removing the load and after 30 seconds without zeroing the stopwatch I'm recording the remaining deformation. I'm starting with Prusa MK4, Polymaker, Bamboo Lab, Creality, Sanlu, Isan, Overture, Everyone, Amazon Basics, Edgebox. And now about remaining deformation, here you can see two examples. This first one was without any permanent deformation after 30 seconds. You can see the results on the left side. And this is example where we have almost 0.03 millimeters permanent deformation. Now later I was thinking maybe with 5 kg load we could see bigger differences between these materials, but for me this deformation is enough, and with 2.5 kg I was sure that we stayed in the elasticity range if somebody wants to calculate the Young's modulus. With 5 kg load I should wait 1 or 2 minutes until the deformation stabilized. But as I mentioned, for me this information is already enough, and it is just hard to justify additional work with so low number of the views. And now the ISAT impact test with these notch test objects to see which material is more brittle or tougher, or is there any bigger difference between them. And for this I bought an impact tester from the eBay, but it is not prepared yet. This is something like NS3 in 3D printing world, so it may be accurate, but it needs some tinkering. So for this video I'm using my DIY impact tester, which has some issues, but for this comparison video, it will be fine. Prusa MK4. Zero position. Now let's switch to this camera, because it will be more visual. This is the scale, the zero position of the hammer, and this is after breaking the Prusa MK4 test objects, Polymaker, Bamboo Lab, Creality, Sanlu, Isan, Overture, Everyone, Amazon Basics, and Hedgebox. The most brittle material was the Everyone, but no significant difference between them. Maybe just to mention the Overture, which was the toughest material, but this was the only one which was in a natural color without any coloring pigments. Maybe this has effect to this impact strength. Maybe an interesting subject for the future video. You already saw the numbers, but the breaks look equally in all 10 cases. Another huge work is finished. And not only the printing or the testing required quite a lot of time, but also the video editing. I hope you like my new method presenting of the results, and you click that notification bell button too, because if you would like to see information about my new uploads, you should click that bell button too, because in most cases, not even my subscribers are not informed about new uploads. Not sure why, I mean, YouTube really tries to stop me here, but I have Patreon supporters, and until that, I don't care. I will do these testings, and thanks to them actually I could do this big testing, because for example Overture, Hedgebox and Amazon Basics I bought myself from the US, and actually the shipping cost was bigger than the price of the filament itself. About these filaments, there is a big difference between them. Maybe a bigger difference I can see only on layer adhesion, but a small note here that I printed everything using the same G-code on 245 degrees Celsius. Now they have a different recommended temperature range. Now this 245 was in this range for every filament, but somewhere it was maybe in the beginning of the or on the top of that recommended range, but I decided to do this kind of testing because this is what I was curious for. Write me down in the comment section which one is your favorite PETG brand, and also I would like to know, do you like this kind of videos? Should I continue with ABS? Anyway, thank you for watching, and as always, happy printing!